Believe what began as an industrial accident hundreds of miles away could have such an impact on us. The crude crisis began on the evening of April 20th, 2010. It started as a fiery accident that led to the evacuation of 115 workers and the search for 11 others who were never found. But when the Deepwater Horizon rig collapsed into the Gulf on April 22nd, it ruptured a pipe, allowing oil to begin flowing into the Gulf. Efforts to activate the well's blowout preventer failed. Within a week, operations began to deploy tens of thousands of feet of boom to keep the oil from coming ashore. Other crews tried to skim up the oil or even burn it before it had a chance to reach the boom. On May 2nd, BP began drilling the first of two relief wells designed to intercept the well and then plug it permanently. 6 days later, the 90-ton containment dome designed to funnel the oil up to a pipe on the surface filled with ice and failed. So did another smaller dome called a top hat. This is the same day the tar ball started washing ashore on Dauphin Island. On May 10th, the government approved the use of dispersants to try to break up the oil. For weeks, it was tough to get a straight answer about how much oil was flowing into the Gulf. The estimates started growing, first 1,000 barrels a day, then 5,000 barrels a day, even though scientists insisted the amount was much higher. On May 20th, I talked to BP's Chief Operating Officer, Doug Suttles.
Our estimate's been pretty much consistent since the beginning, which is we think it's somewhere around 5,000 barrels a day, but I think we've always stated it's actually very uncertain.
A few days later, government scientists raised the daily estimate to 12,000, then 25,000, then as much as 60,000 barrels of oil. That's more than 2.5 million gallons of oil day after day, week after week. And that's the equivalent of the Alaskan Exxon Valdez disaster every 4 days. In late May, BP launched another attempt to stop the oil with a top kill operation to block the well with mud and debris. That failed. On June 4th, BP fit a containment cap over the well, enabling it to capture some of the oil escaping from the well. 10 days later, President Obama visited Theodore in Pensacola.
There's going to be harmful effect on many local businesses, and it's going to be painful for a lot of folks. Folks are going to be frustrated and some folks are going to be angry, but I promise you this, that things are going to return to normal.
July 12th, BP installed a new tighter fitting cap over the wellhead, raising hope that the flow of oil could be stopped from polluting the Gulf for the first time since the disaster began. And finally, on July 15th, oil stopped gushing into the Gulf for the first time since the leak began. And this afternoon, the Sierra Club says that civil lawsuits should result in penalties topping $60 billion, which it says better reflects the harm the BP inflicted on the Gulf.